Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome back, my friend, to my channel on YouTube. It's called Drilling and Workover. This is me. I am Abdulaziz Gabr, the instructor of IWCF Well Control. For the previous lessons, we have talked about the types of pressures and about the leak of test and the MASP or maximum allowable surface pressure. Today we have very vital and very important lesson we will take. It's about the calculations of volumes and about the some calculations of the pressures in order to help you in solving the kill sheet. But first of all, you have to know how to calculate the volumes. Okay, let's go. First of all, what is the meaning of capacity? The capacity means the volume per feet, which means that the capacity of the, for example, for a drill pipe, means the inside capacity of the drill pipe, means the volume that 1 feet of the drill pipe have. Or the capacity of the annulus means 1 feet of the annulus, how many barrels in 1 feet of the annulus. So this is the meaning of capacity, okay? So the capacity, how can we calculate the capacity? Okay, it's barrel per feet. How can we calculate it? First of all, the internal diameter square, and this internal diameter in inch. In inch, for example, if you have 3.5 tubing or drill pipe, 3.5 here, its internal diameter is 2.991, so the capacity will be 2.991 square by 1029.4. Okay, and the result will be barrel per unit feet or barrel per feet. This is called the capacity. Okay, what is the meaning of volume? The volume means the number of barrels that the vessel, for example, or the drill pipe or the tubing contains. For example, the volume of the drill string means the volume in drill collar and the volume in drill pipes. The volume in the open hole means from the TD here or the TD until the show. All this is the volume, or this is volume. The volume of the annulus means from the TD until the to the rig floor or the to the flow line. So all this is the annular volume. So what is the meaning? How can we calculate the volume? It's the capacity multiplied by the measured depth. The measured depth, not the true vertical depth. And as I told you, when you are calculating for pressure, you have to use true vertical depths. When you are using volumes and to calculate volumes, you have to multiply by measured depth. So the volume equals internal diameter square by 1029.4 multiplied by measured depth. Okay. What's the meaning of displacement? Look. Assume that the well is totally full of mud, okay, and this is the drill string is out. So once you are running hole with the drill string, there is some volume will be displaced, okay. For example, some volume will be displaced out. It depends on if it is open jets. Open end string, like bit without nozzles, and there is no float valve here, so it will be open. So, and for this example, only the metal displacement of the tubing will make displace to the volume. But if the bit is plugged, or there is here float valve, or blah blah, there will be much more displacement volume, which is about the total capacity of the metal displacement and inside capacity of the tubing. This will make high displacement, so you should take care of this. So the metal displacement, how we calculate the metal displacement? Also, once you are below to fall, the metal, this metal displacement will make the level of the hydrostatic pressure of the mud to be dropped. So it must be compensated from time to time. And for this reason, there are some problems may occur due to the not filling the well with the proper metal displacement, and so that some cakes occurs. And this is very important question. And this for this reason, especially the driller can avoid this problem by compensating with the proper mud, with the proper displacement from time to time. So take care. Very important to know the displacement. Displacement of the driller pipe. The displacement per barrel equals the outer diameter square of the drill pipe minus the inner diameter square also of the drill pipe. All of this divided by 1029.4. All of this multiplied by measured depth. So take care of this formula. What is the annular volume? Annular volume is here. Okay, annular volume is the space between the open hole or the casing and the drill string. So take care of this. How can we calculate it? The annular volume in barrels equal the inner diameter of the hole. For example, the inner diameter of the hole here. This is the first one, and also the inner diameter square of the casing here. This is the second one. Minus the outer diameter of the drill pipe, the outer diameter of the drill pipe here or of the drill collar here, whatever the place is, square, this is square, minus, this is square, minus outer diameter of the drill pipe square also. All of both of them are divided by 1029.4. All of them also is multiplied by measured depth. And this gives you the volume. So this is how to calculate the volume. The volume to know also the volumes and everything. Okay. In some questions, it's called running hole or pull out of hole with dry pipe. As I told you, dry pipe means that the only used is the metal displacement. Dry pipe means that the well here or the bit here is not plugged or there is no float valve here, so it's just the drill pipe running hole or pull out four with the same. So this means open end drill pipes, open end drill pipes, and the only compensated volume is the metal displacement only. The metal displacement only, outer diameter minus inner diameter square multiplied by divided by 1029.4 multiplied by measured depth. Also, running hole or bullet of hole with wet pipe means that running hole or bullet of hole with closed end drill pipes. So the volume is the pipe capacity, the drill pipe capacity, inside capacity, for example, okay, plus the metal displacement, the metal displacement. So our compensation or our law is the outer diameter, because outer diameter here includes both of them, okay, divided by outer diameter of the drill pipe, for example, divided by 1029.4 multiplied all by the measured depth. That is called wet pipe. Wet pipe means, as I told you, that there is something here which prevents the communication between annulus and the drill string. Okay, so this means that the bit may be plugged, or there may be here a float valve or something like this. So this is called wet pipe. Wet pipe, because when you are blowout of hole, there is something here which blocks the way blocks the way to make communication with the annulus. So once you are blocked full, all of this volume has mud, so you have to compensate from the annulus to avoid any problems of drop in level of the hydrostatic pressure. Also, some mud pump calculations. There is something is called pump output. While you are pumping with the mud pump, there is something called BOB or pump output, which means how many barrels are pumped through one stroke. Actually, you as a supervisor or as a driller, you are not. It's not obligation for you to calculate it or to know it, because you can just ask the tool pusher or ask the driller to give you the pump output, and he will give it to you. But sometimes if you need to check about it, it's better. It equals the inner diameter of the liner, in mud pump, multiplied by the length of the stroke, multiplied by the efficiency of the mud pump, and all of them is divided by 4.116. This means that this is conversion number. For example, in some problems may occur to the mud pump calculations due to the efficiency it's given, but you have to check about the efficiency. How can you check about the efficiency of the pump? Actually, you know the pump output, and then you have accurate volume, for example, of 50 barrels, and you have empty tank or empty bit, and you have to transfer from this bit to the empty tank and to calculate how many barrels it takes and the total strokes. And for this type, you can make or make editing to the pump output, or you can make recalculation again for the efficiency of the pump. Number two, the bottom up strokes, number of strokes for bottom up. The bottom up means that the annular volume means the number of strokes that the cutting takes to go to go from the bit until it reaches to the flow line. So it resembles the volume of the annulus. Okay, so the bottom up strokes equal to the volume of the annulus divided by the pump output. The volume of annulus is barrel and divided by barrel per stroke, so the total is the number of strokes. Why we use the bottom up strokes? Actually, when we use the driller method, there are two circulations. The first circulation is to circulate the kick out, and this can be calculated by one bottom up of circulation. So you have to know the total number of strokes per one bottom up. The bottom up volume or the bottom up time in minutes equals the volume of the annulus divided by pump output, also divided by the stroke per minute. And for this, you can know the time for one bottom up. The hydrostatic pressure in PSI, as I told you, it equals 0.052 multiplied by mud weight in PPG, multiplied by true vertical depth in feet. As I told you, the difference between the volumes in barrel and the pressure is the difference. And the pressure needs true vertical depth in feet, but the volumes need MD or measured depth and also in feet, so that you can calculate the volume and calculate the pressures. At the end of this lesson, thank you very much. I hope that you can know the calculations. Inshallah, we will take another lecture. It will be about how to know the calculations and about the ABI formula. Then we will take about the MASP and leak off test. I hope this lesson appeals to you and it is very easy lesson. Inshallah, tomorrow with new lesson will be taken. Thank you very much. If this video appeals to you, please make like, share, and subscribe in our channel. This is your channel, and thank you very much.